and welcome back to Alan Antimatter's Vinyl Community Channel. Today I thought I'd show you some of my Def Leppard collection. I've been a fan of Def Leppard for many, many years. When I was a kid, about 12, 13, I was majorly into Queen, especially after Live Aid. And then I wasn't really aware of other sort of hard rock stroke metal bands. And Bon Jovi were probably the first big one that I got into. They were on Top of the Pops. Here in England, of course, that was our big music program. We only had four channels in those days. And Top of the Pops was on a Thursday night, about 7:30 at night. And that just used to show what was in the charts. And I remember one particular Thursday in 1987, Def Leppard were on it doing Animal. And I just thought they were so cool. There were quite a lot of old bands, a lot of rock and metal bands I considered to be quite old at that time, whereas Def Leppard were very young, like Bon Jovi, so they appealed to me as a kid. And Animal kind of had a heavy guitar sound, but almost like a Queen style pop metal chorus, which appealed to me. So that Christmas I asked my parents for Hysteria, which was the current album, and I must have played that until it went transparent because I loved it so much, and I still play it now. I mean, it must have been played at least once a week, every single week since it came out in 1987, or since I got it anyway. So I thought I'd show you some of my Def Leppard vinyl. Pretty standard, but I'll take you through them. First album, On Through the Night. Now this is the one that the heavy metal connoisseurs like. There's a lot of people who don't like them after this album, and that's fair enough. It's very on par with stuff that was around at the time, like Iron Maiden's early stuff, Saxon, that kind of thing. It's got a sound of, you can hear the sort of Thin Lizzy, Judas Priest, UFO influence. The last track, Overture, actually sounds a bit like Yes in places. But it's a very, very good album. I love it. I don't think Joe Elliott, the lead singer, thinks a lot of it these days. But yeah, I still love this one. On Through the Night. The next one they brought out, 1981, was High and Dry. Now this one was produced by Robert John Mutt Lang, who had just finished doing AC/DC's Back in Black album. And it shows, because on this, the production has sort of stepped up a gear, and there's some very AC/DC style riffage going on, and they still have that sort of Queen influence. If you listen to the ballad on there, Bringing On the Heartbreak, very Queen-like, and I'm a big fan of AC/DC, hence the hoodie. And so yeah, I enjoyed this one. It is very AC/DC-like. At this moment, we've still got the heavy metal fans on board, I think, by the time this came out. The next one was the one that really broke the doors down in America for them. This, of course, coincided with the birth of MTV in America, which we didn't really start getting here till the late 80s, early 90s. But in America, I believe this was a massive album, Pyromania, with the hit songs Photograph and Rock of Ages. It's a game changer, this one. I mean, they probably had a lot to do with getting that 80s sound that lots of bands, I don't want to say copied, but were influenced. You know, bands like Rat and Warrant and Cinderella, and maybe even Bon Jovi to some extent, probably took a lot of influence from Pyromania. A great album, again, one that I've played to death. And you have to, if you're American and you're watching this, you've got to realise that, you know, I was listening to the radio all the time during my youth because I had young parents, and you never heard Def Leppard on the radio up until Hysteria. Pyromania, absolutely no awareness of any of it existing, none of the singles. It's quite bizarre that they're probably one of our biggest exports and they never got played. Anyway, this was the one, Christmas 87. This was the biggie, Hysteria. It's kind of like the rock version of Michael Jackson's Thriller. It had something ridiculous like 7 hits on it. Animal, Pour Some Sugar On Me, Hysteria, Love Bites, Rocket, Armageddon It. The whole thing is absolutely fantastic. I cannot emphasize how much I love this album. It's brilliant. And the great thing is, this December, they're coming to Nottingham playing this in full, and I cannot wait. Brilliant. That is the original one that my mum and dad bought me for my birthday when I was about 13, 14. And it still plays fine, but it's very, very crackly. So I bought a second one, and also I've got it on CD as well. And then that's had a good battering over the years. Now, obviously, after Hysteria, there was the death of Steve Clark. And they came back in 1992, which was 5 years later. It's a long time in rock music. And they sort of revealed the new lineup at the Freddie Mercury tribute concert at Wembley, which I was at. I was there with my dad, my brother, my mate, John Fowler. Sorry, I didn't say brother, cousin, I meant. And yeah, the new guitarist, Vivian Campbell. And it was really exciting because right near the front, and Brian May joined them for Now I'm Here. And this was the album they had out at the time. This was Adrenalize. This is a picture disc, limited edition. And the big hit off this one was Let's Get Rocked. They had a lot of other big hits. A lot of people went off them after this. I've got to say, I love it, to be honest. Absolutely love it. And this is also from the Hysteria era, this one, going back a bit. That's just an interview with Joe Elliott, but it's a nice piece of vinyl. Now, from Adrenalize onwards, of course, most of the albums tended to come out on CD. I think you can get Slang now, but they are reissuing all those that were kind of CD only. So we're talking Retroactive, Slang, X, Euphoria, Yeah, all those. Songs from the Sparkle Lounge. Of course, with the vinyl revival, vinyl's back big time, and I've got the latest album, and it is absolutely fantastic. Typical Def Leppard. I mean, the current song that you can probably hear in the background, Man Enough, sounds very much like Another One Bites the Dust by Queen, but that's no bad thing. So that's the latest one, and just a few 12-inch singles to show you. Photograph, that was written about Marilyn Monroe, of course. Too Late for Love, they were both off Pyromania. Pour Some Sugar on Me, which is a limited edition triangular shaped picture disc. It's got all the tour dates on there, look. Hysteria, Love Bites, special DJ edition of Love Bites. Rocket with Release Me, the old Engelbert Humperdinck track on the B-side, performed by Stumpus Maximus and the Good Old Boys. You're going to have to Google the story to that. And Let's Get Rocked on picture disc with the original receipt there from Our Price. And Have You Ever Needed Someone So Bad on picture disc. So for now, that is my Def Leppard vinyl collection. Obviously more coming out soon with the box sets. I've been Alan Antimatter. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. It's been a pleasure. See you soon. Bye bye.